Hello?
Joy Behar, please.
I'll see if she's here. Who's this?
Oh, Joy, it's Dr. Kat. Hey, first of all, thank you so much for taking the time to do this. I know that your schedule is nuts.
Yeah.
Doing
what? What am I doing?
Just you have a million things going on, according to everything I... It seems like this is a really crazy time of your life. But thank you for having me on the show.
No kidding. Am I in the segment?
You are the one interviewing me because of a previous relationship, which...
Oh, wait a minute. Which Dr. Katz is this? The dermatologist?
No. You were my patient years ago. I'm a therapist. And I've written a book called Marriage, The Three-Legged...
I remember you now.
Yeah.
Look... I don't really like to talk about my personal life and the fact that I was in psychotherapy.
No, that's not even going to come up.
Oh, okay.
I understand there still is a stigma around it, and that's one of the things I talk about in my book. But the name of the book, just to give you a little heads up, is called Marriage, A Three-Legged Table.
Who thought of that?
That was my idea. It's a metaphor for a good marriage.
That it has three legs?
Yeah, like a kitchen table or something. That the stability of a marriage would depend on having.
But what are the legs? What do they represent?
Well, the first leg, and of course you have to start here, is trust. Trust is the starting point of any serious relationship and any good table, really.
But it doesn't really make a great table when it only has three legs.
No, I think if you visualize a kitchen, like a kitchen table, you know, with
what's the second leg?
The second leg is love.
Oh, yeah, love.
Because you can trust somebody all you want, and if you don't love them, why do you want to be stuck at a table with them?
Uh-huh.
So
Dr. Katz, I don't really have that much time because I'm going to be going on the air soon. So could you get to the third leg?
The third leg, and Joy, this is really, just like with a table, the third leg would be meaningless without the other two legs.
I see. Do you really have any idea what this third leg is, or did you just put it there so that the table would stand up?
Joy, I wrote the book.
And so what is the third leg?
I just have to refer to my notes because I focus on the first two-thirds of the book on the first two legs.
How long ago did you write the book?
About a year ago.
And so you forgot what the third leg is. I understand. As far as I could see, you never even sustained a relationship with a person of either the opposite sex or your own sex. And so I don't get that you're an expert exactly on the subject. Look, that doesn't mean anything. We have plenty of guests here who knows diddly squat about what they're talking about. So you're just one of many. But still, since...
Well, Joy, in my own defense, I did try... I had a marriage which lasted almost 10 years, and it produced a wonderful son...
Well, fine, but you know what? In the span of life, if you're going to live, how old are you now? Like 70?
No, I'm 59 years old.
Are you only 59? Oh, you seem older. Let's say in 59 years on this planet, and only 10 of them were spent with a partner. I don't think that makes you an expert. I'm sorry, but it just doesn't. In fact, it makes you what you said before, the L word.
That's just the lining.
I'm curious, Dr. Katz, how did you exactly get my cell phone?
I told them I was your doctor. And they just...
Well, they thought that you were Dr. Katz, the dermatologist. You see, I told them to put Dr. Katz, the dermatologist, through because...
Sure, there's nothing you can say to a dermatologist that you can't say to a therapist.
No?
The third leg...
I don't mean to be hostile to you, doctor,
no.
I've got to get on the air in a few minutes.
I hope that the tension and the anger I hear in your voice has nothing to do with me.
Well...
Let me rephrase it. How are you?
Well...
Yeah.
I feel very stressed out.
Do you want to talk about that?
Well...
What's going on in your life that's so stressful?
You know, this show is very... It has a lot of pressure. You know, I have to sit with three other women, and I am an only child, and it has been, you know... So it's not that easy to share the spotlight with all these women. They interrupt me, and that's stressful.
Do you feel like life is a competition?
I see where you...
I think that you often, if I remember correctly, put too much pressure on yourself to be the best Joy Behar there is.
Yes, I do. That's true. Even when I was a kid, I was like that. and, you know, I have wounds from childhood. We've been over this so many times, you know, when they used to call me Brillo Head, and that was my fifth grade teacher.
That is the kind of thing that you never get over.
Really? What do you mean? How could you say such a thing to me? After all those years on your couch and all the money I've spent, you're telling me that a bunch of Elvis Presley impersonators in Brooklyn are going to scar me for life? I object to that analysis that you just gave me, that I'll never get over it.
The fact that you are such a healthy and fully evolved woman, so accomplished both personally and professionally, is a coincidence. I mean, a tribute.
What do you mean it's a coincidence?
I didn't mean the word coincidence. I mean, it's a tribute to your strength.
You said coincidence, and you know what Freud said. There are no accidents. That was a slip of the tongue. It's not a coincidence.
No, I often...
Don't say that word again.
Okay, I apologize. That was a mistake. That was...
Yeah, you know, sure, something, Dr. Katz, now I'm starting to get nervous about the interview. Because you're talking about marriage in a theoretical way in this book, and your three-legged table and all that stuff.
Well, that's a third leg to his discretion.
Well, I hope that you are fully aware of that third leg, because when you go out there, I don't want you to have some kind of a breakdown in the middle and say, oh, Joy Behar does not have multiple orgasms. I hope you don't do that, because that will be really bad.
That is not America's business.
Exactly.
Okay, and Joy, the important thing to remember in therapy, in life, in show business.
Dr. Katz, I hate to interrupt you, but, you know, I have to go on the air now, and your segment is not till next week, and I really haven't read your book yet anyway. So why don't we continue this, maybe do this again next week, with a producer in the room?
Wait, who else is going to be on the show?
The day you are on?
Yeah.
Mel Gibson.
Perfect.
He wants to be on with Jews.
It's very Katie Couric to have your an on-camera circumcision.
That's what makes us a hot show.
Yeah. I heard that he was doing Fiddler in Great Neck. Is that true?
No, Rosie O'Donnell is.
Oh.
You know something, Dr. Katz, our time is up. I know that you appreciate that phrase because you've used it yourself many times, but I really have got to go. I mean, we have it's live in about 5 minutes, and I don't even have my pantyhose all the way up. So thank you so much.
Okay, I'll talk to you soon.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.